Okay, good morning all of you. Okay, today we will see the problem number 2. Okay, in a steam nozzle, the steam expands from 4 bar to 1 bar and the initial velocity is 60 meter per second. Okay, initial pressure is 4 bar and final pressure is 1 bar and initial velocity is 60 meter per second and the initial temperature is 200 degree centigrade. Okay, determine the exit velocity if the nozzle efficiency is 92%. Okay, efficiency of nozzle we are finding based on the actual enthalpy drop and theoretical enthalpy drop. Okay, actual enthalpy drop divided by theoretical enthalpy drop, that ratio will give the efficiency of the nozzle. Always actual enthalpy drop is lesser than the theoretical enthalpy drop because of friction losses during the expansion and design of the nozzle body. Okay, the efficiency is less than 100%. Okay, so the nozzle efficiency is the actual enthalpy drop and theoretical enthalpy drop. If you know these two values, you can easily find efficiency of the nozzle. Okay, in this problem also the efficiency of nozzle is given, that is 92%. And what is the exit velocity of the steam? Okay, actual exit velocity we have to find. Okay, theoretical exit velocity also you can find and actual exit velocity also you can find. In present problem, okay, we have to determine the exit velocity of the steam if the efficiency of the nozzle is 92%. Okay, see, the given pressure P1 is 4 bar and 200 degree centigrade and initial velocity V1 is equal to 60 meter per second and exit pressure is P2 is equal to 1 bar, efficiency of nozzle is 92%. And from the steam tables, you have to take the enthalpy of the steam at pressure P1 and 200 degree centigrade, that is 2860.5 degrees, 5 kilojoule per kilogram. S1 is equal to 7.17 kilojoule per kilogram. And HF2 and HFG2, SFG2, you have to take at the pressure P2. P2 is 1 bar. At pressure P1, P2 is equal to 1 bar. You have to take a SF2, HFG2 and SFG2 and SF2 values. Okay, and S1 is equal to S2. The expansion of the nozzle always follows isentropic. That means, okay, the nozzle body is insulated mostly and we are considering the expansion of the steam inside the nozzle body is follows isentropic expansion process. S1 is equal to S2. In this relation, you can easily find the X2 value, and from the X2 value, you can easily evaluate the H2 value, HF2 plus X2 into HFG2. Okay, why we are considering the dryness fraction? Means after expansion, we are expecting the dryness fraction. Okay, H2 value you can determine. After finding the H2 value, the enthalpy drop H1 minus H2, we can easily calculate. And after that, actual enthalpy drop. In given data, the efficiency of the nozzle is given 92%. If you multiply that 92% with theoretical enthalpy drop, you can easily get actual enthalpy drop inside the nozzle body, 0.969. Instead of that, you have to take 0.92. Okay, this is 0.92. 0.92 into 255.1. Okay, then you can easily evaluate actual enthalpy drop. After calculating the actual enthalpy drop, you can easily determine the actual velocity of the steam velocity, actual velocity of steam at the end of the expansion process. Okay, in this expansion, exit velocity we can easily calculate. Okay, this is the formula for efficiency of the nozzle, that is actual enthalpy drop divided theoretical enthalpy drop divided by actual enthalpy drop. From this expression, you can easily determine the exit velocity of the steam. Okay, in that manner, you have to calculate the exit velocity.